be thyself, O King of peace. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Morning.
slain is making all things new.
Good evening. Good evening and Merry Christmas. Welcome to Crossroads Community Church. It's so good to gather on this holy night as we celebrate and give thanks and glory to the Lord for sending our Savior, Jesus Christ. Remember the words of the angel on that night. Fear not. For behold, I bring you glad tidings of great joy that will be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Would you stand together as we give glory and worship Jesus, Emmanuel, God with us. Let's sing together. Oh, come all you faithful. We praise your name, O Lord. Oh, come.
Oh, come.
Yeah.
come.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare Him through. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And
Jesus, we love you so much. We thank you so much that your Holy Spirit is with us tonight. Lord, you made some beautiful promises to us. You said, draw near to me, and I will draw near to you. Lord, you promised you will seek me, and you will find me when you seek me with all your heart. Lord God, we think about the wise men on that day. Brothers and sisters, those wise men were seekers. You know that? They sought. They came from great distances because they saw the sign. They saw the star in the sky. And so let's take the hearts of the wise men tonight and seek our King Jesus.
We three kings of glory and are bearing gifts. We traverse afar. Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never, over a soul to reign. Oh, star of one, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Frankincense to offer have I, incense, O the deity nigh. Prayer and praising, O men raising, worship him God on high. O star of one, the star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume, fragrance of life, of gathering gloom, sorrow, sighing, bleeding, dying, seal in the stone, old tomb. Oh, star of one, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Glorious now, behold him arise, King and God and sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, sounds through the earth and skies. Us to thy perfect light, and guide us to thy perfect light.
amen. Lord Jesus, thank you so much. Lord, we do praise you that you are the light of the world. And God, even these 2,000 years later, our prayer is the same, Lord. Guide us into your perfect light, Lord God. We thank you for this holy night, Lord Jesus. I pray that you would help us, Lord, as your sheep, as your children, to not miss the sacredness of this night, Lord, to not miss the holiness of this night. Oh, night divine, Lord, we praise you, Lord. We praise you.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. Would you pray with me, please? Oh Lord, on this Christmas Eve, we pause to prepare our hearts for a beautiful celebration,
the celebration of your birth and coming to earth as our Lord and Savior, Jesus. Clear our minds so that we can focus on you and the joy that you bring us through your gift of salvation. May the same thrill and anticipation that filled Mary, the chosen mother of Jesus, consume us and draw us close to you. And may our spirits cry out, Alleluia, with the host of angels who cried out and first delivered that good news of great joy to those humble shepherds. The news that would literally one day be heard around the world. Lord, we want to share that news and bring joy. Lord, we know there are those who have suffered loss this year and not everyone feels joyful. And so we pray for them, Lord, that you would touch their hearts with love and compassion. And for their losses, we pray that you would dry their tears with your sweet comfort and cheer. Turn their sorrow into joy as only you can. Lord, we ask that you would forgive us of our sin and anything that would inhibit or block the celebration. We surrender all. We pray that we would receive your all this Christmas Eve night. Whether we are here by ourselves or with our family, we want to prepare our heart individually for you, even as you are preparing a place for us to join you one day. May every thought, every desire, every word, every gift-giving action that we have this special time, we pray that it would usher us into a place where you meet us as we are. And as we share our gifts with friends and family, we bring you gifts too. The declaration of our obedience, our devotion we give to you, and we quiet our heart and spirit and the joyful overflow into worship and adoration tonight. May this preparation be a holy night as we once again receive and celebrate your great gift to us this Christmas. And we pray all these things in your precious name. Amen. Amen. Be seated, please. I'm Jenny Bullis, Program Director at Crossroads, and we're so glad to have you here in our service tonight. And as many folks from long ago or have brought family tonight, it's so good to see so many faces. And we pray that you would be blessed by this worship service and that you would go out to be a blessing to others as you meet this special worship time, this holiday time. And if you did not get a program and would like one, please lift your hand. We have some ushers that have programs that are going to, has a special message for you in the back as well about our church, and we hope that you'll take a moment to read that. If you need something to write with, just lift your hand. They'll give you something to write with. We also, every time we meet together, we ask that you please share your prayer request with us and your blessing, how God has blessed you, and you can put that on. There's a tear-off portion there in the program. You can tear that off, and you can drop that into our offering basket as it's passed a little later in the service, and we will pray with you, and we will be thankful to God and joyful with you as you thank God for every blessing that he has given you. So I just want to make a couple of announcements known to you. We ask you to, tomorrow morning, worship at home with your family and loved ones, and we thank you for being here tonight, but we thought it was important for our volunteers that have come early every service. They come 2 hours early to prepare, and we thought it was important to also allow them to spend Christmas morning at home. So we thank you for that, and if you would like to share, we are live streaming the program tonight, and it will be available as well as any other service that we have at Crossroads. If you go to Crossroads MD, Crossroads of Harford County, Maryland, on YouTube, you can find any number of services that we have been live streaming. For those of you that participated in our Living Nativity, please bring those costumes back clean, and you can leave them here in the lobby, and I'll be taking care of those in the next few weeks. Oh, and a quick announcement. There is a white Mazda SUV in the parking lot. The interior lights are on. So if you were parked in the handicapped area with your white Mazda SUV, so run to go get those lights turned off, and you'll want to run because it's cold. We're going to have our regular service on January 1. So we'll be here regular service on January 1 at 10:30. We're going to take our offering in just a little bit after Advent, but I just want to let you know that every Christmas Eve, since we began Crossroads, we have given a portion of our offering to Alpha's Glory, and we will be doing that again. Alpha's Glory is a crisis pregnancy center in Aberdeen, and we are just happy and blessed to help them help other women as they have a unplanned pregnancy or a difficult pregnancy that they perhaps did not want, but we encourage them. We believe life begins at conception, and so we want to encourage them to keep those babies and love them and bring them up in the admonition of the Lord. So just to let you know that we'll be preparing our offering a little earlier in our service than is typical, so you'll want to be aware of that. Okay, and today we complete our celebration of Advent. We have celebrated together for 4 weeks. Advent means coming, and we use candles as symbols of our celebration. And during Advent, we anticipate the celebration of Christ's birth on Christmas Day, and we anticipate his second coming as Lord of all. This year, our Advent celebration aligns with our sermon series, which has been All We Have to Give. We invite someone from our congregation to lead this portion of the service. Tonight, the Police family had planned to leave us, but the children are sick. But Chris is going to lead us, and I'm going to assist.
Thank you, Jenny. My sister in Christ, we're still family. As we prepare for Christmas, we take time during our worship service to celebrate Advent. Advent is a time of waiting. It's full of hope for what is to come. It's a time of preparing our hearts and our homes for Christmas joy. Tonight, we celebrate God's revelation of true love in the person of Jesus. Our theme for Advent this year is All We Have to Give. And so tonight, we have the special joy of lighting the Christ candle, the big white candle in the middle. Our Old Testament reading comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Our New Testament reading comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 10 through 14. Then the angel said to them, do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And so now we relight the first candle of Advent, the candle of blessing, to remind us that every blessing comes from the Lord our God. We relight the second candle of Advent, the candle of honor, to remind us and bring honor to Jesus, the Son of God, who was born to bring salvation to those who believe. Tonight we relight the pink candle, the third candle of Advent, the candle of glory, to announce that glory belongs to the Lord forever. And tonight we light the last purple candle, the fourth candle of Advent. It's the candle of power to tell us that by God's power, Jesus brought salvation to us. And now, my dear friends, tonight, we light the center white candle, which symbolizes Jesus Christ, our Savior, for whom we await his coming, his second advent. So one of the special things we get to do at our church is we get to share a personal testimony of the last year. And so Bethany and I had something to share. I'll share on behalf of both of us. But it's so interesting because exactly 1 year ago on Christmas Eve, me and my family and our kids were at home without a local church. We had no home church. We were helping a church plant in Washington, D.C., and we were driving every Sunday down 95, down through Baltimore, down to D.C., and helping a church plant that's a great church and going on. But we felt the for the first time in our lives, kind of the barrenness of not having a local church home. And then one of the greatest things of our lives happened. We got connected with Pastor Bob, and early this year, we became a part of Crossroads Community Church. Praise God. So little did we know at the time how desperately we were going to need our home church. Earlier on this year, Bethany and I were expecting our fifth child. We were expecting a son. And about 20 weeks along in the pregnancy, that horrible thing happened, and the son we were waiting for never came. We had a miscarriage. And if you've ever lost a child, you know that that is a unique pain. That's a very painful experience to go through. And yet, even in the midst of that sorrow and suffering, I cannot tell you the hope that we found, not only knowing that Jesus was with us, but the hope we found in this church as we were so lovingly embraced. It was one of the most special experiences of our life to not only know God was with us, but to know his people were with us, holding us up as well. And so we found that amazing thing to be true, that in this world we will have trouble, but we take heart because he has overcome the world. Our Redeemer lives. And I just want to leave you tonight with this. If you need a church home, this is the place to be. You have family here. This is a place where the love of God and the hope of Jesus, our Savior, shines bright. Amen. Would you bow your heads as we pray together our Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
At this time, we are going to get ready to receive an offering, and we're also going to have the children come up and prepare to sing. So if our ushers would come forward and the children can get in place, I'm going to say a prayer for us as we get ready to receive that offering. Let us pray. God, you have given us so much, and now we give back to you with a spirit of love and generosity. Please use these funds to bless our ministries, our communities, the peoples of Alpha's glory, and our community. And we pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you. 2,000 years ago, an event took place that changed our world forever. God came to earth in human form to deliver mankind from the penalty of their sins. Jesus Christ, God's only begotten Son and the Savior of the world, was born in a lowly stable in Bethlehem. According to many scholars, he was the King of the Jews, whose arrival had been the subject of many ancient prophecies. Those prophecies had been passed down for centuries and had been taught even beyond Jerusalem. Magi, or wise men, from the East were familiar with the prophecies and also regularly studied the heavens. The appearance of the Bethlehem star was a notable event. Influenced by the prophet Daniel, these Magi believed the star marked the appearance of the King of the Jews and decided to make the long and difficult trip to Judea to see him. They stopped in Jerusalem to share the news with the Jews' political king, Herod the Great, and inquired where the new king had been born. Herod became very upset at this news and sent them on to Bethlehem to search for the child and to report back when they had found him. The star, which they had seen in the east again, went before them until it came and stood over the birthplace of the Christ child. And when they had come into the house, they saw Jesus with Mary, his mother. They fell down and worshiped him and presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then they were divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod. So they departed from their own country another way. We join the story now as told by the wise man known as Melchior.
What a glorious morning. Beautiful today. Thank you. Thank you, Ramon, for this beautiful, wonderful fire that you have prepared. And what a feast you prepared for our morning meal. Bless you, my dear servant. I will pause for the grapes, though. What is that? We have a visitor? A Hebrew. What else? Send him in. Send him in. I'd love to meet him. Welcome, fellow traveler. And may I ask why you are here? And what is your name? Here because of curiosity. We have found that a lot in our travels. And your name? Josiah, because you are of the lineage of David the king. Interesting introduction. And I'm guessing that you told me that because you are here headed to Bethlehem because of the census, correct? Well, we just came from Bethlehem ourselves, and obviously we are not Israelites, so we were not here for the census. My name is Melchior. I'm an advisor to the king Phraates of the Parthians. We are east of Assyria, north of Arabia, and as I advise the king to give him wisdom, he is known, by the way, as the king of kings in that land, because of all the countries that are subservient to him. And what brings us here so far from our home? Well, that, my friend, is an interesting story. And, you know, one that I probably need to learn to tell because it is so life-changing. And to you as a Hebrew, one that you would do well to listen to. Do you have time? Would you care to hear my story? You do? Wonderful. Well, have a seat. Armand, more food and drink for our guests who will be here for a while. Well, not too long of a while, so that I might share all that's happened to me in the last few weeks. As I said, my name is Melchior. I'm known as a Magi. Yes, I know it's the root word for magician. And many magi do use sorcery and trickery to lead people, but that is not my heart. I am a student of nature, of the heavens, a student of man, so that I may gain insights to all that I see to give wise wisdom, give wisdom to the king who seems to appreciate it. So I've been called upon to interpret dreams, to settle conflicts, to give wisdom to our people. The Parthians, very, very confusing group of people. Our beliefs are somewhere between science and superstition. We sacrifice and don't know why. We worship a fire if we care to. So I try to think good thoughts and to do good works. And that is what I try to express to our people. But your people, the Hebrews, they're very intriguing to me. You call yourselves God's chosen people. And then you have the miraculous history to back that up. Abraham, the father of your faith, 100 years old and fathers a child to prove that he will be the father of many nations. And Moses, who has not heard of Moses, born as a Hebrew, yet raised in Pharaoh's household, to return later as an Israelite to deliver them from the slavery of Egypt by parting the Red Sea. Incredible. And the prophets. Oh, how I love your prophets. To read of their wisdom and their confrontation to your people, to tell them of their sin and tell of God's judgment. Yes, Josiah, the world has been watching your history. The world continues to watch when people call themselves the people of God. Speaking of the prophets, of special interest to me is the prophet Daniel. Do you realize that he, not officially, but really is one of the first Magi? As a teen, he was taken captive with the Israelites by the Babylonians. And he learned how to interpret dreams. He learned how to give wise counsel and rose quickly in the ranks of royalty. He would often share his wisdom and was appointed to positions of power. For 70 years, he stood on his principles and he taught and he shared, and his writings, hear me, have influenced Magi for years, including this Magi. A special interest to me was his desire, one, to show people your God, and secondly, to prophesy that there is a coming Messiah, an anointed one, sent by God that your people might be delivered. And if you study the scriptures, you have to know. Josiah, you know that, yes, Daniel in the lion's den, miracles. But do you know his writings? Do you know that he prophesied that this very generation would see this Messiah? Yes, yes. In fact, let me read it to you. I have it right here. This is from Daniel, who says, "In my vision, at night I looked, and there before me was one like the Son of Man, coming with the clouds of heaven." Which brings me to why I am here. As I said, I'm a seeker of truth. I am a student of the heavens, and I believe the movement of the stars and the events in the heavens impact people of all generations, of all places. Several months ago, on one particular night, I was studying the heavens and saw this glorious, wonderful light. Call it a star. It was unlike anything I'd ever seen. I believed at that moment that God was speaking to me in my own language, one who had studied the heavens, that the Messiah was come. I believed it was a sign. Not knowing how long that light would last, I decided at that moment that I must follow the star. So I did. The entourage, you see, we started on the journey, mostly at night because we could see the star, headed to the west. And on our way, I met two more Magi. And the three of us joined our entourages, and they had the same story, an interest in the Hebrew scriptures, a belief that God was sending a Messiah. and the faith just to say we will follow the star until we see the one that we seek. Gaspar, from the far east of Assyria. Balthazar, from the south, from Arabia. You would know him from that country, Arabia. And all of us had such a belief that we were going to see the king that we brought gifts to actually give him. Gaspar brought gold, worthy through all cultures, all of time, worthy for a king to show royalty. Balthazar brought frankincense. Frankincense is an incense, we believe, that lifts our prayers to heaven. And in a somewhat confusing way, I chose to bring the spice called myrrh. Myrrh is used to heal wounds. It's very valuable in our country, and it's also used as a burial spice. I was somewhat confused myself, but felt because of its value in our country, that is what I wanted to give to the king. So imagine an entourage triple the size of this one on its way to Jerusalem, where we felt it's your capital, the king, we would find the newborn king. And what we found was King Herod the Great. Are you familiar with him? Very interesting man, very egotistical, very insecure. Well, we came into his court, and without much, it was pomp and circumstance, but for him, simply, we just said, "Where is he who is born King of the Jews? We have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." Well, Herod was obviously distraught at the news. And just to pause to give you a bit of history. Rome, the power that Rome was, they don't like the Parthians. They don't like the Medes. We were at war several years ago with Palestine right in the middle. Of course, Rome won and has control of this area, and they appointed Herod king of the Jews. So here we are, we who are influencers of kingmakers, if you will, coming right into the midst of this kingdom to say, there is a new king. Of course, Herod was distraught. He was threatened, called his advisors together to say, where is this Christ to be born? Is there a prophecy saying so? And his advisors, terribly nervous, wanting to be as accurate as possible, quoted the prophet Micah and said, "But you, Bethlehem, although you're least among the kingdoms of Judea, out of you will come forth a ruler who will shepherd his people, Israel." Well, for us, I'd never heard of Micah to know that there was prophecy to tell us the place where the star was leading us. But Herod was not as glad. In fact, he took us into his chambers, grilled us with questions, asking us for more information, and said to us, "My dear wise men, I'm very familiar with your influence and effect over kings. This visit of yours has caused me great pause. I have never heard of this prophecy before. So I command you to go and search for this child, and that I might come back and tell me that then when you found him, that I might come and pay homage to him." Well, we said, "Well, Herod, King Herod, why don't you come with us?" He said something about a feast that he had to attend, or that it would be awkward for the current king of the Jews to see the new king of the Jews. It was obvious he was tremendously upset. So we felt relieved to send us on our way. Even though we felt the king would to be born in such a magnificent palace, we were glad to be away from there. And wouldn't you know it, the star appeared again. And of no surprise, headed in the direction of Bethlehem, similar to you. Might I say at this point, Josiah, do you have family in Bethlehem? Well, that is good, because it is severely crowded. There is not a place to rent, a place to stay. So we wish you well in getting that place with your relatives. That room might already be rented out. Well, that is the direction we head. And because Bethlehem was so crowded, we did not stop there. The star led us to a building called, I don't know if you're familiar with this, the Tower of the Flock. The Tower of the Flock is a place where special shepherds deliver baby lambs who are without blemish to be used as the sacrificial lambs in Jerusalem. That's the place where the star rested. That's the building that we found ourselves. We had traveled so far, gifts in hand, entourage behind us, and we were so excited and yet almost afraid to knock on the door. But we did. And a man by the name of Joseph came. A strong man. He had calloused hands. We knew he was some sort of craftsman of wood or stone. And he invited us in. It didn't seem to bother him in the least. And we came, and he introduced us to a young woman by the name of Mary. And Mary was holding a baby. Well, awkward as we felt, Gaspar had no problems breaking through and saying, "We believe this child is the King of the Jews, and we've come to worship him." Thank you, Gaspar, for just breaking through all the formalities. He took his gold, he knelt before him, and he said, "I've brought you this gold because you are royalty." And Balthazar didn't miss a beat to say, "I brought you frankincense because we believe this baby is the priest of God who will answer and hear our prayers." And for me, to say it was awkward was an understatement, because I brought my myrrh. And it said, "I've brought myrrh, very valuable in my country, but it's a spice used to heal wounds. It's a spice used for burial. Forgive me if it's inappropriate for a young baby." But it didn't bother them. They proceeded to tell their story. They said that an angel had appeared to Mary and to Joseph. The angel came to Mary and said, "She is a virgin." I didn't tell you that. She is a virgin and became with child by the power of God's Spirit. And the angel appeared to Joseph and said, "You shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." Well, I said to them, what does that mean? Well, they quoted another prophet, the prophet Isaiah, who said, "Unto us a son is born, unto us a child is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace." These were titles that resonated with us as kingmakers to say, this is the king we were expecting. But then, they went on. Isaiah went on. He says he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace will be upon him. And by his stripes, we are healed. He said that all we like sheep have gone astray. We've each turned to our own way, but the Lord has caused the iniquity of us all to fall on him. This is not the king we expected. We expected a majestic king overthrowing the Romans, setting up his kingdom on earth, and now we heard this king is to be a suffering servant. This king is to be a sacrifice for our sin. And then they told us of the journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem, the long journey, and how there was no room for them and ended up at the Tower of the Flock because of a kind innkeeper. And after the birth of the child, who would appear but shepherds who told them the story of angels appearing to them out in the fields as they kept watch over their flocks, singing praises to God, the hosts of heaven, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Oh, Josiah, don't you see? Your Messiah has been born. And I believe my Messiah has been born, not just for the Jews, but for the Gentiles as well. Praise be to God. Well, with these stories and all that was affecting us, I had to ask, Mary, can I hold the baby? And she said yes. And she placed this little child in my arms. And I've blessed many, many children. But this child blessed me. As I looked into his eyes, and he looked into mine, I felt a peace deeper than any I've felt in my whole life. And I came to realize that this God-man, the Son of God, the Messiah of the world, had made the heavens that I studied. He made the star that I followed to find him. And he would give his life that I might know Almighty God. Josiah, I'm so glad to come to know your Messiah. And you need to know him as well. Well, it was so difficult saying goodbye and seeing their poverty, unlike what we expected. We were all feeling regretful because we did not bring everything we could give. But we said our goodbyes and we thanked them for their obedience, for their time with us, and left there as blessed men. That night, from the exhaustion of the trip, from the exhaustion of all that we heard and what we were led to believe, I slept deeper than I'd ever had in my life. And for the first time, God appeared to me in a dream. And he said not to go back to Jerusalem, to Herod, but to go to our homes another way. And believe me, I didn't have to ask twice. I did not want to see Herod again. And at that morning at breakfast, Balthazar, Gaspar, the exact same dream. And so we departed, and here we are, headed home. Ah, I miss that star. We've had to rely on travelers such as yourself to just give us directions. But we are different men. We are going home to tell a story. And my story is going to be difficult because I now serve a new king. I will serve no other. You know, rumor has it from people that we have met in traveling that Herod is not only threatened, he is now threatening to do away with Jesus. But not knowing where or who he is, we've heard that he is planning to kill all the infants in Bethlehem, 2 years and younger. That grieves me. But I know this in my heart, that as God provided for us to go home another way, he'll provide for this family. He'll be sure that this rightful king is protected. What a story. What a true story, Josiah. And that those are the key words, the rightful king. He is the one that Daniel prophesied. He is the one that God has prepared that, yes, as a child now, but will grow to be a man to provide for us for our sins. I believe that with all of my heart. And I desire that for you. What is that? If I were you, what advice would I give? Well, as a matter of fact, I'm used to giving advice. So I will tell you three things. One, I've learned that God speaks to us in the environment in which we live, in the world in which we have grown accustomed. For me, it was the heavens, and God spoke specifically because that's where I was looking. Where are you looking, Josiah? What do you do? Ah, you're a businessman. Ah. Well, then I would say this to you. Pay attention to your customers. Be fair in all your business dealings. And as they share with you about your business, listen. They will be good teachers. And God's the ultimate teacher. He will speak to you in that realm. Secondly, I would say this. I would say that when God does speak, act immediately. As I did to follow the star, I would now call a step of faith because I didn't actually know what I was doing, but I just went. And when God then breaks through and says something, do it. Even when God redirects your path, as he did with us, to send us home another way, often God will do that. We make our plans and God says, here's where I want you to go. Trust him, Josiah. And finally, you're headed to Bethlehem. And I would say if he's still there, seek out Jesus. And you will find abundant life. Thank you. Thank you for being such a good listener to my story. And as I tell it, I hope I grow better with the facts and all that God is doing. So it's time for you to go. I know you need to go. And so all the resources I have are yours, whatever you need to be on your way. But you must go. You have someone very important to meet. Shalom.
Shalom indeed. Christ has come to bring peace on earth. Let us stand together as we close this special Christmas Eve service by singing Silent Night.
Silent Night, Holy Night, all is calm.
Just our voices, verse 1.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant, so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
Amen. And now receive the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you now and forevermore and bring you peace. Go in the love of Christ and have a very Merry Christmas. Amen.